Steve Dotto here. Today's topic is going to be task list managers. Now, this is one crowded app space. There's probably more task manager apps than any other app. Now, some of them are part of big ecosystems that fit in with Time and Contact and all those other managers, and others are just simple task managers. Now, what I was looking for in a task manager was cross-platform compatibility. I wanted a manager that I could use on my computer, on my desktop computer, be it Windows or Mac, that would also give me this flexibility to have those lists and to share those lists with my different mobility devices, my iPad, my iPhone, my Android phone, any type of other mobility device that I wanted. And again, there's lots to choose from. One that's really highly rated is one called Wunderlist. I imagine it's Wunder, not Wonder, but Wunderlist. It is from Wunderkinder, a company that's developed this very simple, free app. Key feature of this app is it is available everywhere we are. It's available in Macintosh, Windows, Linux, iPhone, iPad, Android, BlackBerry, Windows Phone, and of course, on the web as a web browser. Installed it, like it, think it's really elegant and simple. That's what we're looking for in a task list manager. So let's take a quick look at the app itself. Now, when you first install Wunderlist, they ask you for an email address and a password. That effectively creates your account. They don't ask for a whole bunch of extra information, address, credit card, any of that stuff. The account is quick and easy to create. Now, looking at your actual list manager, we see we've got all of our different tasks here in white. We can add new tasks by clicking in the top and typing in the new task. We have the ability to, of course, apply a timestamp when it's due so that we know exactly what the due date is, so that we can search down here in the bottom on tasks that are due today, tomorrow, the next 7 days, etc. We also have the ability to, of course, add text to any task, to add notes about the task. And then there are a few sharing options for our tasks. Up at the very top, as you create each task, you can ask it to be printed. You can email all of your different tasks. If you just click on that, it takes all of the tasks that are in whatever list you're in. Here I'm in my inbox, which is kind of a catch-all for all my tasks. And it creates a list of all of the, it creates an email with all of my to-dos in it, which I think is very useful. And they also have this ability here to share with Cloud App. What this does is it actually creates a URL that is a unique URL that you can then share your list with others, but either by them just clicking on the URL, or you could say embed this URL in Twitter so others could see the task. Now, once it's uploaded, it's not editable by anybody, including yourself. It's just a kind of a publish this list. People can then see it. It lives on the internet for 30 days and then is gone. So it's not really a project management tool at that point, but instead just a very quick and effective way to share a list, to share a task with a group of people by whatever way you want, by email, by sharing it on Twitter, by those sorts of things. So we've got this window here which has all of our different tasks. Now, when you first install it, they of course give you a whole series of tasks which are basically just a little tutorial of how to use the software. But you add structure by having all of your tasks and then creating lists against those tasks. And we go here into the right hand side, click add list, and you can add a new list. I'm creating a vacation task list here, and because I'm heading off on holiday in a few days. So I've created a shopping list. I can now go in. And I can create all of my different shopping items that I need. Now, of course, this is only valuable if I can get to these tasks what I need. And that's really what I was looking for in a task manager, was something cross-platform, something that I could use my other devices and access the same list, see my tasks, so that I can do them when I'm in the field and I only have my mobility device in my hand. Let me show you how that works. I have fired up my iPad and installed the HD version of Wunderlist on the iPad. Beautiful, clear resolution on the iPad screen, and we can see the exact same list. It syncs automatically between my different lists on my computer, on my iPad, it would be the same on my iPhone or my BlackBerry or my Android phone. If I go in and take a look at the list, there's the vacation list that I just created. I can quickly gain access to the note that I just created. If I'm out now shopping, I can be on my iPhone. I can take a look. I can see the list of different things that I need to purchase, and I can check them off, and I can take care of my list while I'm in the field. And of course, if I want to add new tasks in the field, I can add them while I'm traveling about, and then they will be reflected back through here on the desktop version next time I sit down at my computer. You know, increasingly in the Apple world, we are dividing these different vertical tasks into their own apps. Apple really started that process by having Apple Mail and the calendar app separate, as opposed to in the Windows world, where in Outlook we looked at adding them all together. The idea of having all of your different apps separate has a lot of appeal. We give up something in some of the flexibility and connectivity within the app itself, but what we gain is really easy access to the same data on different devices. In this particular case, having the exact same account on a Windows, Mac, on an iPhone, iPad, Android, BlackBerry, Windows Phone, you name it. You can set up your lists, your tasks, and you can access them from whatever device you happen to be using. And I think that is a really nice way to approach it. There are certainly going to be more robust and bigger apps available to us that do more things. But for simple task management, this might just be the ticket. I hope this video has been useful. If it has been, please give us some social media love. How about a thumbs up, a like on Facebook, tweet us out, or subscribe to us here on YouTube. Also, drop by our website at dottotech.com. If you found this video useful, there are many more videos there. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for your time today.